Let us continue about few more projects using applying the concepts that we have learned in this course. Now, this is the third case studies. Here also again we will discuss two projects. The first project that is we are going to discuss about the systematic design towards an advanced calculator. Now, we have already have an idea about how a calculator can be designed, and now we discussed about how the same can be applied to develop more advanced calculator. So, first phase that we will consider about designing a simple calculator using the simple features, this is the beginning of the projects, and then we will slowly try to add few more features. For example, few more functionalities, more operations, equations, others, and then finally, we will develop an advanced calculator having more complex functionalities like this using brackets, bracketed expression, and then some others also, and then scope of customization, setting the styles and everything. So, let us discuss about the flow of the projects, the different steps or the versions of the project. In the first version, as you are very much familiar to this kind of projects, and we have developed this kind of project using applet, you can do it in the using simple non-applet program also using swing or AWT as well as anyway. So, both applet version and then non-applet version program also can be written for this purpose. So, this is very simple. We have already have an idea about that this is a few buttons are to be there, one text field area will be there, and then user perform any operations. Those operations are basically binary operations like no unary operation, for example, square root, cube, log, all these things not involved here. So, it is simple. So, here you have to just create the layout and then include certain component into that layout, and then finally, you have to add the listener methods so that events can be handled. So, there are many programs you can find in the internet so far the Java calculator is concerned, right. You can check all the programs, those are available, try to understand those programs. In this course also, we have used several programs for Java calculator. As a Java calculator, you can nurture those programs also, then you will be able to learn it. Then you can try to modify of your own, like say setting the different fonts or the button color or whatever it is there, so that you can exercise whether the change that you have desired, whether you can reflect it into the program and you can see it or not. So, this will basically gives a lot of practice, and then as a beginning of the design of a calculator, this is must actually. Now, our next part is basically is a little bit improved version. So, this is the simple calculator we have already learned about. After learning the simple calculator, our next step, this is the basically simple calculator as we see, and then we will be basically change this into this one. You can see the difference here. The difference is basically as we see the difference here is basically add few more buttons as we have mentioned here. So, few more buttons we have added here, like say C buttons, C means clear, then is a okay, whatever the previous calculation we can load into the memory and then read, or memory can be clear, and here we have used one more functionality, say square root calculation or square calculation, whatever it is there. Now, I can advise you to have this is a usual symbol, not the square level, the square root symbol can be put into there also. Okay, so, we have checked that okay, after adding this one, how the same calculator can be improved to have this kind of look, and how the event handling operation related to this C, M or MR, MC can be added there. You will be able to try to do that, and then okay, you that is the only thing that you have to apply your ideas about how these things can be done. So, let us see whether you can do it or not. In case suppose you are finding any difficulty, we will be available to have any interaction, not the direct online interaction rather. You can send your problems through mail, or you can request for an interaction program so that we can sit and then discuss and solve the problems. But before that, you should fire all the problems to us so that we can go through the problems and then get ready to resolve it quickly. The next version of this is basically to have the more improved calculator design. So, this is the last calculator version. We have to change it into there. As you see, in this calculator version, we can do many things. So, the previous calculator is basically adding two numbers and operation, then it will give the result. But here, we can do say add, sub, division together many operations and then finally the result. So, 5 plus 6 plus 10 into 2 minus 8, that is the result will be calculated like. So, this calculator will provide these facilities. In addition to this, this calculator also allowed to have the bracketed expression. Bracketed expression means is basically within this bracket. So, 2 plus 3 multiplied by say 5, it basically give the result accordingly. So, the brackets and then complex bracket, all the matching parentheses should be there, it should be. In case of there is an error in the matching parenthesis, your calculator should report an error message on the screen, I mean text fill area instead of the result. And so, this is the method that we have discussed, is an improved version of the previous one. You have to add few more buttons, and then for each button you have to add the listening methods. And then finally, the next is advanced calculator design, and as you see little bit more buttons are there, and here I have made it little bit open space for you, so that you can think about how more advanced calculator, more sophisticated calculator can be designed. You can follow, for an example, the Casio math calculator, which is very famous among the students, popular among the students. So, you can follow this calculator and see whether the same can be developed in your Java environment. And you can see many calculator available in your Windows environment, in your Linux system, as well as if you have the mobile also, you can find many calculator there also. You can think about the calculator that you can develop in Java can be exported to your mobile setting, so that mobile app as a calculator can be used, your advanced calculator. Now, let us see what is the advanced component that we are thinking about. So, power button that we have considered, that means if we click the power, for example, so all the things will be dimmed and then there will be no highlights like that. It seems that the calculator is power off like, so it is power on and off like sort of thing. So, some setting changes, and after that power on and off, if anybody use any keys and everything, so calculator will not work for you. So, it become disabled, and then there is about, so here you can see the different other component style. So, suppose you have to change the background, because I do not like this background. So, user can customize the background color, foreground color, font size, and then orientation. If you want to change the orientation in this slide or everything, that you can allow using this one. And exit, basically if you do certain changes, whatever it is there, exit. Now, you can replace this exit button with some other buttons, like all other trigonometric functions, say sin, cos, tan, cot, like this one. That also, if you collect it, and then this operator will add, because if you add more buttons, the size of the applet will increase, and at the cost of size of the fonts and button size, and then error will be there. If you want to click this one by mistake because of the small size in button, you go to the some other button or whatever it is there. So, in that case, some other functionalities like log functionalities, trigonometric functionalities, or some other functionalities can be added there also. Okay, so, this way the calculator can be improved, and another scope of improvement is that so, log table also can be there, and then some statistical table also can be added into this log this calculator itself, so that in the memory the table will be stored, and whenever you give any value, say degree of freedom and then the value, then it will result the return. So, if you are little bit knowing about the statistical process or statistical tables or distribution function, all these things, those also things can be incorporated into it. There are many scope of improvement again. Now, here we have designed the calculator in English, but those do not know English, for them how this calculator can be facilitated. So, for these things, all the things which are there in English, it can be converted into other language, Hindi or some Telugu or Tamil like. So, here all these characters can be changed, it is just minimum effort is required. So, in the style file or about or in the setting file, you can change that calculator in which language. So, language setting also can be there. So, lot of things can be done, and this way you can innovate that how you can better calculator can be designed. And the calculator design is a very good example for, and usually many teacher, the many author also, they prefer that calculator should be discussed while they discuss the different Java concepts. We have done the same thing also here, but there is a starting point. You can go on and carry with this and then learn many things are there. Now, let us come to the next projects. This project is again very similar to the project, as you can see. If you are familiar to Kon Banega Crorepoti, right? So, there is one quiz game is there, where Mr. Bachchan, who is basically conduct this one. So, we can implement the quiz game application, but Bachchan should not be available all the time. So, in place of Bachchan, our computer can play the role of Bachchan. So, here a questions, a quiz can be popped up from the repository, and then user will be allowed to select an option, and if it is a correct option, his score will increase, and if it is a wrong option, or if it has suspect about any results, then just like a Kon Banega Crorepoti quiz, it will basically give that 50% off, then accordingly the score will be reduced, and then only two options will be given. Out of these two options, you have to select, all those things can be done. So, this is the exactly quiz game application, it is there. Now, let us see what is the idea, and for this obviously things to implement it, the different concept that you have to apply, Java Swing is required, event handling, IO stream is needs to be followed, and JDBC also to be there. So, if you have the confidence about all these concepts, then definitely you can start. Even if you do not have any confidence also, let us start dealing with these projects and then try to learn as it is required, and then this is also one way of learning process. Now, here is the idea about quiz game application. So, first of all, you have to create a question bank. The question bank means it is basically set of all questions, maybe 500, maybe 5000, maybe 50000, absolutely no issue, there will be no limit. And then the question bank needs to be prepared, and this question bank needs to be maintained in a server. So, in this way JDBC coming into the picture, database server is coming into the picture. I will tell you the idea how this question bank server can be created in this project, and then user will be allowed to play. For this game playing, definitely there should be one GUI to be developed. So, a GUI based engine needs to be developed by which it can play the game. It will basically ask what questions, then questions will be there, options will be there, then select button will be there, other options will be there, so many things are there. So, GUI program is basically front end for the user, and there are many facilities, flexibility, so the game can be tuned as per the different twist and then requirement is concerned. Now, let us discuss each step one by one, so that we can understand about how the project can be carried out one by one. So, the question bank database server creation, there are two things that can be done. You can add the database by using the SQL commands that is there sitting on the console, typing each command at a time and then adding the record into the database. Now, here I want to say is that if the database table needs to be created, then what will be the structure of the table? It has one field about the question itself, then other four fields for the four options, then another field, the sixth field, it should be the correct option, because this information is required so that program can process it. And then whenever this database, whenever the game is in running condition, it will fetch one question as well as all options and then correct option, and then it will throw the question as well as options, and then we will select the choice from the user, verify the option with the correct one, and then accordingly score will be calculated like this one. Now, one process that I told you that you have entered the data one by one, but 500 entered data, those are the text and then typing error and everything. So, it is very difficult. So, we can write one program automatically. That program will basically take as an input as a document file, and then that file will scan and each record will be entered automatically to the server. So, that file can be created using an Excel sheet like, and I have given an idea here, CSV file. It is just similar to Excel file, only the comma separated. So, each field will be separated by a comma. You have to scan it. Whenever you find a comma, you can take that this is the one field value and then go into that field value, the next and so on, so on. So, this way 6 field question, 4 options and then correct option will be selected and then accordingly populated to the database server. So, here is the idea it is given, this is the CSV file that you created and that can be cut and paste for document can be created and then one. And that program if you run with another CSV file, it will automatically update the database easily just running the program itself. So, developing the program only the issues are there, but it is only few lines code is required. Let us try to do it, how the CSV file can be read and then content can be retrieved and the same content can be sent and executed as an insert record to the database server. So, this way it can be done. And another thing that okay, there are as a database administrator, you can create the database table also from the JDBC also, you can create the table, absolutely no problem, whatever the way you can do there. And there may be different topics can be included in your game. So, the some topics may be say related to the politics, some may be related to the entertainment, some may be related to the other topics say computer science or physics, chemistry like this one. User can be given a chance that from which topic he is interested to play the game. So, accordingly topic can be selected, maybe 2 or more topics can be selected, so that the question can be fetched from all the topics that the user has selected like. So, topic wise the different tables also can be maintained and it can be updated into the server or data can be loaded with the corresponding topic tables and so on. So, this is the data entry so far MySQL server database creation is concerned. And here is the GUI for gaming. At the very beginning stage, you can have a very simple look of the game. As you see here, it will first discuss the question number and then the question will be appear here and then 4 options like option 1, option 2, option 3 is there and then all the options are not highlighted. Whenever you just select an option, it will click it and then here another option that the correct option which will be selected will be displayed. Or if the option that has been selected is not correct, the correct option actually according to this question will be displayed there. Anyway, so it will after selection of an option, the correct option will be displayed and accordingly the score also will be computed. So, this GUI program will take care everything. So, here the interface to be developed and for the event handling routine has to be written so that it can do the work as per the requirement is there. So, this is the idea about the first phase of the program. In the second phase, GUI plus program for gaming, as we have seen that at the front end the GUI should appear and at the back end there are lot of other activities should be carried out for which we need to develop socket program, because this GUI should interact with the socket. That socket will be responsible through the server, so that our network if your server is not connected is in the same machine, then you have to do it anyway. So, if you have to have the access to JDBC, then you have to have the connectivity and everything are there, whether in the host machine and the game playing machine in the same system or in the remote system, whatever it is there. So, you can develop the socket program for that socket will basically run the networking and then JDBC related programs elements, and then this is the back end program actually. And then this the program will take a selection from the user. At the end of the round, the correct option will be highlighted and score will be updated. These are the program activities that it should go. The game will continue until there may be say 15 rounds, or until there will be an option that if he wants to quit, then the quit option should be asked from the user and then quit it. And then finally, the game, whenever it is over, then the total score that he the player has achieved will be displayed on the screen, and like this one. So, this is the idea about second version. And then third version is basically let us improve the interface, as well as the interface will change, all the backend program also has to be changed, all these things that you have to do it. Here I have given some idea, but you can think some better idea than this one. I wanted to make the idea a little bit simple, so that you can implement, you can handle this project in a shortest possible time. And here is the idea that we are going to see here, the topic selection should be given as an extra facilities to the user. Earlier version it was not there. So, topic 1, topic 2, everything is there, start quiz, and if it is start, then this button will be changed to the stop quiz like. So, this button will be in a toggle mode, 1 start means it will start, and then everything will start like this one. And whatever the topic that you selected, that topic will be highlighted here, so that user can understand that on which topic he is giving the answer. And so, in this case only one topic that one user can be selected at a time. So, at every round the user can change this topic, and then accordingly the question will be faced, the question will be displayed here. These are the all same things it is there. So, as we there, and then so here again another facility. So, this is the another improved version of the layout that you can think about, and this is the another more improved version where we can add few more button as we see. So, remove one question, remove two question, and all these things. So, remove one question means it is basically 1/3 score will be reduced, and then out of 4 it basically only 3, out of which 1 should be the correct of course is there. Remove 2 question means 50-50, right, means it is basically 2 questions will, 2 options will be removed, and then only 2 options out of which 1 is there. So, is basically then the player can guess more precisely, so that the more score can be there. It is just like a in the form of a kon banega korpati quiz style, and then this is the interface that you can develop it. So, here basically few more buttons can be added, and for these buttons you have to add the interface program accordingly. So, this is the 7th program, and this is the quiz playing game actually we have discussed. I hope you are finding this project interesting, and these are the small projects as obviously, because the purpose that I have already told you is a motivated with that you can apply your learning skill to developing this project. And this project also you can carry out as your undergraduate project curriculum also, if you are an undergraduate students like. And so, this way you can learn much more, and then I have given the initial idea, not necessarily initial idea is you can improve this idea of your own. Creativity is an essential part should be that the software engineer should have. So, I have also that expectation from you, so that you can add few more novelty, more creativity in the project. So, these are the seed project we can say, starting with this one, then improve it, and then see what are the best product you can develop. Thank you for your all endeavor. Thank you very much.